Robots, automatic pet feeders, movie props, drones. The list of cool projects that combine the power of 3D printing and electronics is endless. That said, some if not most of the projects can be pretty intimidating. And you can get easily discouraged when you realize that you need to learn how to solder, write your own code for an Arduino, or design a circuit board. Well, fear not, because this time you won't need any of that. And yet, we'll light up our 3D prints. You generally have three options when it comes to simple light sources that work well with 3D prints. And that's LED strips, LED light bulbs, and small diodes. One of the easiest ways to add lights to your 3D prints are LED strips. They are cheap, often come with a remote, they are available both white and as RGB, and most importantly, they are really easy to power. You could buy a whole roll of an LED strip and use your own LED controller and a power supply, but not this time, we said no soldering. So instead, we suggest buying an LED strip with a USB connector. This way you can power it with any old phone charger, your PC, or a power bank. The obvious downside of USB is its limited power, so you can't get really long or extremely powerful LEDs. But really powerful LEDs also run pretty hot, so we wouldn't want to use them anyway, especially with PLA. LED strips always come with a double-sided tape applied to their bottom side, so it's really easy to install them. If you stick them on the inside wall of a box, you can get nice and even illumination. Then print a front plate with a text or a logo, and you'll end up with a similar result as our recording sign. Alternatively, you can print and wrap a cylinder with the LEDs, and this way you'll have the light coming from the center of the object. Consider printing a diffuser from, for example, clear PETG. That will make the illumination more even and hide the individual LED chips. A cool thing about LED strips is that you can cut them with regular scissors to adjust the desired length. The spots where you can cut are always clearly marked, so make sure you watch out for them. Oh, and LED strips work great as a light source for the build plate. Using light bulbs with 3D prints is pretty straightforward. For example, if you want to print a hanging lamp, simply pick a shade you like, print it, which can usually be done without supports, and then you just have to buy a light bulb socket with a cord and attach it to your 3D print. Old school light bulbs were terribly inefficient and produced a lot of heat. Luckily for us, LED light bulbs are mainstream these days, and the amount of heat that they produce is significantly lower. Still, be mindful of this, and check how hot does your light bulb get. You're most likely not going to 3D print all of your lampshades, maybe just a few of them as cool design piece. In this case, modern smart bulbs are a great way to make your creation even cooler. They can be controlled with a voice assistant like Google Home, Amazon Alexa or Apple HomePod, and change color on demand.
Google, turn the lights on.
Sure, turning two lights on.
Here are some smart light bulb options. There's the Xiaomi E-Light, which is significantly cheaper than the competition, and yet it's fully featured. Then there's Philips Hue, which is expensive but has lots of fancy accessories. And then there's Life FX, which is also expensive but has a greater maximum brightness. Whichever light bulb or cord set you choose, there is one challenge in front of you, and that's hooking up the power. Mains electricity voltage can seriously burn you or even kill you. So, if you don't know what you're doing, please just stop right here and consider asking someone with more experience for help. But if you know what you're doing, it's as simple as switching the circuit breaker off, triple checking that it actually is off, connecting the face, which is brown or black, and the neutral cable, which is blue, insulating the connection and turning the power back on. Most cord sets even come with a quick release mechanism for the cable connection. The two previous solutions were for rather big prints. In contrast to that, individual diodes can be really tiny and fit almost everywhere. They are usually powered by 3.3 volts, which is uncoincidentally the voltage of most button cells. For under $10, you can get a set of hundreds of these diodes in various colors, which will usually last you, well, forever. To attach the battery to the diode, you can either use a rubber band or a printed part. We've used this technique in our Halloween Crow and in our miniature tabletop gaming video. We've just scratched the surface with using electronics and 3D prints, but adding even a small light to your 3D print will really make it pop. Would you like to see more videos about electronics and 3D printing? Let us know in the comments. And as always, happy printing!